Let's see what we can do to upgrade your Gardevoir V-Battle deck. Welcome back, everyone, to more from the Sableyes. I'm Mitch, and today we're going to take a look at the Gardevoir V battle deck and see how we can upgrade it to get some wins on the ladder on PTCGO. Yesterday, we took a look at the Victini V battle deck, upgraded that one. We're going to do the same thing today, so hopefully you enjoy it. If you do, go down below and like that video. It is the single most valuable thing you can do to help your favorite content creator. So this is the Gardevoir V battle deck as it is presented to you out of the box. It features this Gardevoir V promo card with Swelling Pulse for 3 energy, 120 damage, plus if this Pokemon was healed during your last turn, it does 80 more damage. 200 for 3 is pretty solid. There's a couple of healing options in here, but to be honest, I don't really think that it's that good of a theme deck. The thing that really jumps out at me, though, is this 3-3-2 line of Infiltrator Dragapult, and I think this is where we're going to focus our upgrade video, because this card is really, really strong. The first thing that we need to note about it is its attack. Phantom Force for 2 psychic energy, deals 120 damage, and then places 3 damage counters on our opponent's benched Pokemon in any way we like, and that's really strong. It's a solid attack. It's very reminiscent of Dragapult VMAX's attack. VMAX obviously does slightly more damage. The Dragapult baby needs a little bit more work to get there, but it does a similar thing. The thing that this card does, though, that sets it apart is it has the Infiltrator ability. If any damage is done to this Pokemon by attacks, flip a coin, and if heads, that damage is completely prevented. And that means that this Dragapult card can stay alive infinitely, depending on how lucky you are. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take this card and build our upgraded deck around it. Unlike our Cinderace deck from yesterday, the Victini one, our ability-based Pokemon that supports the Dragapult is not quite as good. Healing with the psychic energy is obviously much better for Gardevoir, but I don't think that it's realistic to get 4 copies of Gardevoir and then upgrade it into something that's workable, so I decided instead to focus on the Dragapult. Again, plenty of decent cards, but if you're just going to get the V-Battle deck, I would say the Victini one is slightly better. We'll jump across and see the upgraded version now to see exactly how we're going to get the best out of Infiltrator Dragapult. So this is our upgraded version, and you will notice that there are some significant changes from the V battle deck. Obviously, our main attacker is still the same, Infiltrator Dragapult. We've got the Snorlax engine from our Victini V battle deck upgrade, but the rest of the deck is very different. Now, to be honest, this deck is going to be a little bit more difficult to get hold of, especially since we're looking at a couple of copies of the supporter card Rosa, which is quite expensive, but it is definitely still worth a crack. And since we've got copies of cards like Scoop Up Net, we can also play cards like Mind Report Mewtwo to get some supporters back. We can do a little bit of energy denial with Team Yelgrunt and Crushing Hammer, and we've got EXP Share to help us keep our energy in play. So there's lots of things that we can do. Obviously, we are heavily reliant on getting the Infiltrator ability to flip heads so that we don't get damaged, and that's what I'm going to be trying to do as I take this one over to the PTCGO ladder. So we have a start, we've got a Gormandize Snorlax, and we've got a Quick Ball, so we can grab ourselves a Dreepy. We need to get those in play as soon as possible. We'll attach an EXP share and then Gormandize. We missed out on an energy, unfortunately, and we don't get one out of that hand either. So that's a bit of a disappointment, but on the plus side, we have the Rare Candy and we have the Dragapult, so it shouldn't be too much to ask to get a Dragapult in play next turn. In saying that, though, traditionally, when I say that I've got a pretty good hand for next turn, I tend to get Marnied, so I'm not attached to what we have in our hand at present, because I'm expecting that to be shuffled to the bottom of the deck, quite frankly. Our opponent on... it looks like they're playing like a Zamazenta. It happens every time! Oh my goodness. It's more the fact that I mentioned it. More than anything, it looks like they're playing a Zacian and Zamazenta deck. They've Marnied us actually into a Rare Candy and a Dragapult anyway, so that's pretty good for us, I think. And they are just going to Intrepid Sword, so that's acceptable. They've had a bit of a slow start. We've had a bit of a slow start. It's all looking okay so far. Let's Great Ball. We find a Dreepy, which is great. To be honest, probably could have just quick balled for that. We do find another EXP share, and we can rare candy into our Dragapult. But again, we need to find some energy. There's only 9 or so in the deck, so it's not like they're always going to pop up. But we have seen we've seen all but 37 cards of our deck. And remember, we had a pretty big hand that got shuffled to the bottom as well. So we are a little unlucky to not have seen any so far, but that's okay. We don't really need them right now anyway, to be honest. As long as we can get our Dragapults in play, we can rely on a couple of coin flips to go our way. Eventually, we'll find some energy and we'll be able to get an attack off. And the good thing is, if our opponent does play just simply a Zacian and Zamazenta deck, which it's seeming like they're playing at the moment, we may see Luka Metal later on. We haven't seen it yet. Then we will be half-hitting everything on our opponent's side of the field. Phantom Force deals 120 damage, and the highest HP that they currently have is Zamazenta with 230. Although in saying that, we are about to see a Cape of Toughness, which is going to mean that there are some extra damage counters needing to be placed on this Zamazenta. So, yeah, I should just stop talking. And ultimately, we might be a little bit more successful, but that's okay. They're Intrepid Sorting again, so they've got nothing, which is lucky because we've got nothing. There's an energy. That's fantastic. Let's attach to the Dragapult. Then we can do some quick balling here. I think we get rid of the Yelgrunt's fine, and then we can grab ourselves another Dreepy. We just want to set up as many Dreepy as we can. We'll flip heads on this Crushing Hammer. Damn, gave it a crack. And then Wilmani away and try and find ourselves a couple of good consistency cards. And to be honest, this hand looks pretty solid. We've got a Dracloak, which we can use to evolve into off of the Dreepy that was on the bench last turn. And then we have a Rosa for next turn, so when they inevitably knock this Snorlax out, we should be able to go for another Dragapult. And luckily, we've actually got one in our hand as well. So next turn, it would not be unrealistic for us to have 3 Dragapult in play. They knock out the Snorlax, we evolve the Dracloak into a Dragapult in our hand, then we Rosa for a Dragapult and a rare candy, or we get Marnied. Again, I should have mentioned it. That's okay. We've got the one Dragapult, and that's all we need. We just need some energy so that we can start attacking, and it looks like that's what we have. We've got another Dreepy as well, and a Snorlax, so pretty solid, not great, but acceptable, and we'll be able to get some damage onto this Zacian this turn, because it looks like they are going to start attacking, which is fair enough. Now, if we're playing up against Lucario and Melmetal, this is the turn when they'll really punish us. We can attach an energy to the Dragapult, and then they go into their Lucario Melmetal and just destroy all of our energy. That would be incredibly frustrating. But you know what? Sometimes it just happens that way. We will attach to the Dragapult. We'll play down all of the Pokemon in our hand, and then Phantom Force deal some damage and place our 2 damage counters onto Zamazenta so we can get that little bit closer to a 2-hit knockout. And that's pretty solid. We've got the Snorlax on the bench, so next turn, if we want to, we can retreat into the Snorlax to draw some more cards. I wouldn't have a problem doing that, to be honest, because our hand at the moment is not particularly strong. Like, 2 rare candies is not quite where we want to be. Also worth noting, you don't have to play with the gold versions of these cards. I should mention that, because sometimes I think people go, oh my god, this is a very expensive deck, and then they get turned away from it. But you can play the regular versions of these cards. I just like to play the shiny ones. So that's just me. You don't have to do that. Looks like our opponent's just going for the Intrepid Sword. Fair enough. Oh, we've got a Great Ball. We may as well play that. Hopefully we find a Dragapult, and we do, so we can at least use one of these rare candies here to get into a Dragapult. That's pretty solid for us. And then I think we're fine to just retreat into the Snorlax and draw some more cards. No point attacking into that Lily's Pokédoll that achieves absolutely nothing for us. So no reason to waste time doing that. We might as well just retreat for free because Dragapult has free retreat and get that Snorlax into the active. Now, if our opponent does choose to attack this turn, that's fine by us. We've got plenty of options. We've got a cascading line of Dragapult there. We've got the Dragapults, we've got the Dracloak and the Dreepy. So any other Dragapults in our hand, equal evolution. It looks like we've got that there. And it looks like they are actually going to take the knockout on the Snorlax this turn, which is a little bit disappointing. But to be honest, we are at the point now where we've got pretty much everything that we need. We've got all of our Dragapults set up, or at least most of them, and we've got energy to burn. So I think it's as simple as just attacking every turn until the game ends one way or another. And look at that, we've actually managed to top deck another Rosa here. So this will give us, I think this will just give us our fourth Dragapult. So I think that's probably the best thing to do. We'll just grab a Dragapult, we'll grab a Rare Candy, and we'll also grab a Psychic Energy. That seems perfectly reasonable. And now we've got four Dragapults on the field. So if you can get four Dragapults in play, you're looking pretty good. At the moment, though, our opponent hasn't really achieved too much. We're going to Phantom Force here, and we'll just place those 20 damage counters onto the Zacian. And they'll be deflected because of the metal goggles, so whoops. Doesn't really matter. They would have gotten rid of them on the Lily's Polkadot anyway, so it's not that big of a deal. They can't knock us out with Assault Tackle, though. That's an important thing to note. This Zamazenta cannot take a one-shot knockout on the Dragapult, even if they do manage to get the heads flip. And there's the Lucario and Melmetal, so that is genuinely frightening. I don't want to have to deal with that. If they remove all of the energy from my Dragapult, I am in trouble. Luckily, though, I do have an energy in hand. I've got a Dragapult on the bench, so it should be fine. But, you know, not ideal. Now, they're Assault Tackling here. They flip tail, or we flip tail, so they do get to hit into us. But we've got free retreat, so I'm not really too worried about that, to be honest. it's not that big of a deal. I think we just attach to the other Dragapult. We might actually just send that one into the active. I don't think that there's any risk in doing that. We can deal 120 damage, put that pretty close to being knocked out, and then we'll just place our three damage counters on a Lily's Clefairy doll and knock that out so that they can't use it. Did I say two damage counters earlier? If you've commented and said, Mitch, you said two damage counters, I thought I said three, but it's fine, because I've caught myself now, so you can put a little edit down the bottom and say, he figured it out. You're welcome. They're going to boss this Dragapult again. They're Assault Tackling, but I flip heads. That beautiful Gardevoir coin. It's actually a really nice looking one. And fair enough, I'd concede after that too. We managed to get the victory over Lucario and Melmetal. Bit of a tougher one here. Looks like we're up against a Blastoise V deck, which is very interesting. We'll be going up against the last V battle deck that was released, that Blastoise V. Will we be in trouble? Will we? I'm not sure. It's going to be an interesting game for sure, because I don't actually know how the Blastoise's bench damage is worded and whether or not we get to flip coins to prevent it or not. So we'll have to wait and see. Our opponent just simply switches into Cryogonal. That's fine by me. We will attach an energy. We'll play Great Ball. We'll grab the Snorlax. This is looking pretty good. We can play that down. We can scoop up our Dreepy, and then we can start drawing some more cards. To be honest, we probably just play the Marnie here. We'll Marnie our opponent and give them as few cards as possible, and we give ourselves as good a hand as possible. And I tell you what, that is a pretty good hand. To be honest, I think we just Gormandize this one here. We've got Rare Candy and Dragapult for next turn. We have Energy, we've got Rosa, so if they knock us out, we can draw some more cards. It is looking pretty good. Just watch out for the Marnie now. Either that or they just Frozen Lock me, and I don't think I can get my Snorlax out of the active. These are all risks, but you know what? They're risks that I'm willing to take. To be honest, if they spend 13 turns using Frozen Lock on my Snorlax, then that's just the way that it's gonna go. Alright, so we're sitting and we're waiting, and our opponent doesn't appear to be doing too much, which is a bit of a concern, because if they time out, then I will need to start another recording, which I don't particularly want to do. But you know what? If they do time out, then that's not too big of a deal. It means, of course, that we do have an opportunity to get a scoop up net if we can, preferably off of the top deck, because to be honest, that's the only realistic way that we can get it at the moment. And that way we could attack with the Dragapult that we've got, but you know, I think they might be timing out here. Just sitting quietly. There it is. There's the time. All right. Well, we didn't get what we wanted, so we're just going to Rare Candy into a Dragapult. We're going to attach an energy, and then I think we just Quick Ball away the Snorlax, grab another Dreepy, and then Gorman dies. And if they time out, then you won't see this. So we'll just wait and see. We've got the scoop up net. But I mean, that means nothing if they Frozen Lock. But they won't Frozen Lock because they've not done anything. They wouldn't have just sat there and timed out and then come back and start playing. That very rarely happens. Oh boy. Well, at least I can yawn with no issue. Oh, goodness gracious me. Yep, Matoma. Oh my god, they're playing! Oh my, the yawn stays in. At least for now, they're playing cards. Okay, well, that sprung me into life, hasn't it? They've got the Blastoise VMAX, they've got the Frostmoth, they've got the energy. They must have just been away from their computer for like that one turn. One of those ones where Mum's come into the room and said, Jonathan, you need to do the dishes! And he's gone, my name's not Jonathan, my name is Light456. What is going on? This is supposed to be an informative video, not one where I go insane. Okay, so they're using their Frostmoth. I think we do get to flip the coins because it's damage, right? If they're using the scope, then it's damage. And you'll be like, Mitch, just read the card. I can make the inference. I can figure it out. I think we're going to have to just deal with this Cryogonal, to be honest. I think we're just going to be sitting here waiting for this Cryogonal to either... waiting for him to decide that the Cryogonal is too slow, or until the Snorlax dies. We could be here for a while. If you're looking at this one going, I wonder why this video is 45 minutes long, it's because of this Cryogonal right now. You're going to go for the level ball. They're probably going to grab themselves another Snom or something here, just in case something goes terribly wrong. Looks like that's the correct choice, and then they're going to quick ball and get rid of that Snom. Alrighty then. Instead, they're going to go for a Cricketune. Cricketune's a pretty good card. I don't know exactly what it is you're looking for here, my man. Crobat's a pretty good card also. They're worth two prizes, you know. We could knock some of those out down the line. I think that's probably worth doing, to be honest. Frozen Lock, here we go. It begins. So, our turn is going to be an energy attachment and a pass. Yep, nothing else to do there. We can't draw any more cards. There's no reason to draw any more cards because we can't play the items anyway. So we are literally at the mercy of our opponent here. I'm just gonna lean back a little bit, make sure that I can still be in the frame. We're just gonna have a little bit of a relax. We're just gonna wait and see what happens. Because this Cryogonal could either hit me 12 more times or it could retreat right now. It's a Frozen Lock. All right, top deck and energy. Nope. Okay, pass the turn. So this is obviously a bit of an issue with this deck, but you know what? It's fine. I'm not super fussed by it. I'm just gonna have to sit and wait. Ooh, an energy. We'll attach that. And we'll pass the turn. How was your weekend? Pretty good? Or week? What day is it? What day am I releasing this? Thursday? I don't know, what day is it? In the comments down below, just whilst we're having a bit of a cruisy time here, just let me know what day it is when you're watching this. Not the date, just the day. I just want to have a comment section filled with random days. Because obviously people on the day that it's released will write the day that it's released, but yeah. If you're watching this later, maybe you could say the day that you're watching this. What is this video turning into? Come on, Mitch, let's sit up. Accept the Frozen Lock. Just be engaging about this. Don't just lean back in your chair and ask your viewers to write what day it is. Oh my goodness. There's a part of me that hopes that this game doesn't get through, but you know what? I feel like eventually it's going to finish. At some point, they're going to need to attack with the Blastoise, or they'll knock out the Snorlax. So, you know, it's going to be one of those interesting games here. They're Frozen Locking again. All right. Can we top deck literally any playable card? We can. We have an energy, which we're... You know what? We might hold it, to be honest. We're going to attach it. It's going to be fine. They only deal 30 damage. We will pass the turn and see what happens here. It's entertainment, at the very least. Training Center, that's a good card for us. They get a quick ball here and get rid of one of their cards in their hand for presumably something else. I don't know what it could possibly be. Looks like nothing at present. Do we go for the fifth Frozen Lock in a row? Oh, a Marnie. Well, I never. Perhaps we'll draw into a Bird Keeper that isn't in the deck. Maybe that's what we'll do. To be honest, I'd happily see a Dracloak. And we've got one. Fabulous. Okay. And another Frozen Lock. Brilliant. Excellent. Just love it. We will evolve into Dracloak. I think we're just going to grab this Marnie back, because why not? Because we can. And then we'll Gormandize. Hiya! Hiya! an EXP share that we can't play. Excellent. All right, we've got quite the hand for next turn. We can choose one of two options. We can money or research. To be honest, we might not do either. It's completely dependent on what our opponent elects to do here. They're moneying us again. Oh my goodness. The high-quality gameplay that you're witnessing here today. Thank goodness that we had that game against Lucario Melmetal first, because this one would have been a pretty poor effort, frankly. Oh, they're attacking! Okay, everyone, I don't want to make a big deal about this, but we could be able to play some cards this turn. Like, I don't want to say anything, but we may be able to attack with Dragapult. Now, you keep that to yourself, alright? Because I don't want anyone to feel like we're lying to them. Alrighty, we are away. We've got a Dracloak in our hand, we've got a Rosa. We can search out a Rare Candy if we want to. We can search out... Oh, we've got a Great Ball. Let's play the Great Ball. We find a Dragapult. Oh my goodness, it's all happening. Everything is happening here. We can attach. We can play down the Dracloak if we want. We can play the Rosa even and grab another Dragapult, which I'm going to do. I'm going to grab the Rare Candy and the Psychic Energy. To be honest, we could have done a number of things there. We could have grabbed another Supporter for next turn. But you know what? I'm greedy and I want the Dracloak now. The Dragapult now. Let's just do it. We should flip this Crushing Hammer. And we get our heads as well. Thank you very much. And then we can Phantom Force. Alright, where are we going to place this 30 damage? I think we're just going to put it on the Frostmoth. Just make it as difficult as possible for our opponent to attach energies. Maybe force them to use that Cryogonal again. Good grief, Charlie Brown. Alrighty. We're in a game now. And we also get to flip a bunch of coins, because when this Blastoise uses G-Max Bombard, we are flipping 3 coins for these Dragapults. We got a heads, we got a tails, okay. What? So 30, okay. What? Tails? What? What? How did those... I have no idea how any of those damage calculations happened. I presume, as we just do the same thing that we did last turn, I presume that our opponent, we flipped heads on the active Dragapult and then we flipped double tails on the bench. I think that's what happened. Goodness gracious me. For some reason we flipped 2 heads at once. We flipped 2 tails at once. We'll do it again here, let's see. So tails takes a knockout and deals 30 damage to that one arbitrarily. And then tails and heads. And then... How did that coin flip work? I'm so confused. I don't know what's going on. Let's just take 4 prizes, shall we? What? How did those coin flips happen? Why did they flip 2? Why did they flip 1 and then deal 2 amounts of damage and then flip 2 and only... I don't know what's going on. I don't know what's going on. Regardless, we have taken 4 prizes in this match. And we have a Dreepy and an EXP share in our hand. So things are looking good. As long as... as long as we don't have our hand disrupted, we're looking good. As long as our hand stays the same. Ladies and gentlemen, he said the line. Oh, remove him. Remove him from existence, he said the line. Oh my goodness, okay, Aura Loop deals no damage because we flip heads, which is excellent. We could boss here if we want to. Kind of feel like bossing up this Crobat's a pretty good idea. We can deal some damage, we can Phantom Force, we can place 30 damage on the bench somewhere. I'm thinking that probably, let's chuck it onto the Blastoise, why not? That could be a frustrating one if it evolves into a VMAX. Now this Crobat is a couple of turns away from being knocked out by us. It has 60 HP left. So as long as we get to attack twice, we should be fine. It comes down to, can our opponent Suicune hit us here? We flip tails! So apparently no, we will not be continuing to attack with that particular Dragapult. But because we knocked out the Frostmoth, there's no way for our opponent to easily accelerate energy. So we'll be taking a prize here with Phantom Force, and then we'll place 30 damage onto that benched Crobat, and to be brutally honest, we don't need to do too much more than that. We are one turn away, ladies and gentlemen, one turn from winning with Dragapult in what can only be described as one of the strangest matches that I've ever played on PTCGO. And now our Mewtwo is getting bossed down. They're gonna stall the Mewtwo in the active. And they're gonna frozen lock me. Alrighty, here we go. It's happening again. They're just gonna hit into me a number of times. Alright, so now it comes down to, can we attach two energies? There's a scoop up net. I know what you're up to, scoop up net. We can't play you. You go back in the deck now. No energy, but we have the training court. So as long as the training court stays in play for us, which it probably will, we don't play stadiums of our own, and that was our opponent's, then next turn, we should be able to win the game. Hopefully everything stays the same. I don't think that there's any way that our opponent can possibly screw me here. I think it literally comes down to, can my opponent money me out of my energy and remove their training center and manually attach three times and knock out the Dragapult, and that's the way that they win. I think that's it, but to be honest, I don't see it happening here. I do not see it happening here. And we go for one more frozen lock, which means that yes, we will be able to win this game. We can attach to the Mewtwo and then we retreat. Whew, we got there in the end. That was a very, very interesting one. Phantom Force, in the end, taking three prizes in the last turn of the game. That Dragapult, beautiful card, doing the job for us. Whew, tell you what, that's a time and a half. So now it's time to give this deck a rank. I will say quite comfortably, this one is not quite as good as the Victini V Battle deck. That Cinderace deck is actually really, really strong. Dragapult, I think, is a little bit worse. It definitely relies on your opponent not necessarily playing well. Playability-wise, it does have the opportunity to go up against some of the big decks, but it relies so heavily on those coin flips. I can only realistically give this one a C. Consistency, the same thing. Sometimes you just flip tails and you lose. Plus, if you don't manage to get your Dragapult set up, then you can really do nothing to stop them. Cost-wise, you still get most of the cards that you need out of the V-Battle deck, but to be honest, cards like Rosa push up the price a little bit, so I'm gonna give it a B. You can get most of the cards on the cheap, but there's a couple that you can't. And fun-wise, to be honest, I don't know whether it was just that last game, but I don't really find this deck that fun. The kind of coin flippy nature is a bit of an issue for me. So, but again, fun is, you know, it's subjective. So what do you say to that? Overall, I'm giving this one a C grade. It is definitely a deck that is acceptable, but it's probably not one of the decks that I'd recommend that you go out straight away and get them. V-Battle deck, if you've got to choose, then grab the Victini one for sure. And again, that is all we have time for. Thank you very much for coming along. Appreciate your attendance in this one. Thank you particularly to everyone who went down and liked the video. Appreciate it, as well as those who subscribed and all of my members. You guys are genuine heroes. If you want to become a Sableye, it costs $3. There's a join menu down there. Just click it. Click the button. See whether you like it. Dadbod, Azazel, you guys are ascended Sableyes. Just beautiful. Love it. You guys are the real heroes. Fernando, Yolo, Steven, Agent Abel, Austin, Josiah, Leaf Devourer, Robsy, Caster, Brad, Shings, Brad, Justin, and Krokotaku. As Royal Sableyes, you guys are very, very generous, and I really appreciate the support that you give, as well as all the Mega Sableyes listed in white, all the regular Sableyes as well. Don't forget, I know about you. I've got you on a list as well. You're just not on the screen. Because these guys are on the screen. The screen's very full. Thank you, everyone, for coming along, and hopefully you're enjoying them, these videos, as they're coming out. Tell me what you think about the ranking thing as well. Anyway, I've got to get out of here. See you later, guys. I'll catch you next time for more from the Sableyes.